Well, the Office of the Ombudsman has dismissed the head of the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources for grave misconduct. But employees of the agency are standing by him. Jervis Manan is back with that story. Jervis?
Yes, Tali, concerned employees of the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources expressed support to their embattled chief, Attorney Demosthenes Escoto. Escoto was dismissed by the Office of the Ombudsman on Wednesday after finding him guilty of grave misconduct in the procurement of transmitters and transceivers. In a statement on Thursday, employees said legal recourse is still available to Escoto. The concerned employees said they have taken note of the legal development regarding a case filed at the Office of the Ombudsman against Escoto, and that they are acknowledging that the decision is part of the due process and must be accorded with utmost respect. The employees also said that they believe a higher legal recourse is still available for him and that they are still expressing their support to Attorney Escoto. They also greeted their chief, who is celebrating his birthday today. They said that they are celebrating his life as a dedicated public servant who has untiringly worked for the welfare of the Philippine fisheries sector. Agriculture Secretary Francisco T. Laurel has appointed Isidro Velayo Jr. as BFAR's officer in charge. Velayo was a former regional director for the Zamboanga Peninsula and a former national coordinator of BFAR's seaweed program. Stanley.
All right, Jervis, this is of course coming at a time when, you know, BFAR is also as burdened as other government agencies and divisions when it comes to the challenges at West Philippine Sea. What are you seeing as to the impact of the changes in leadership in the new directions or the additional tasks for BFAR?
Stanley, we have talked to some of the BFAR's employees and they said that while they are respecting, of course, the decision of the ombudsman, they also believe that the new officer in charge will be able to take care of the agency and that there will be no significant changes in the direction as to what the BFAR is pursuing right now. So the mandate will still remain the same despite changes in leadership.
All right. Stanley. For that update, thank you so much, Jervis Manahan. President Marcos named as one of Time Magazine's 100 Most Influential People for the year. Time cited Marcos's efforts to rehabilitate his family's name. Marcos is the son of the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr., who plundered billions and declared martial law, which left thousands dead. Time also cited the younger Marcos's success in steadying the Philippines' post-pandemic economy, as well as elevating the country on the world stage. A former House lawmaker seeking a halt to the pole automation contract between the COMELEC and South Korea's Miro Systems. Adrian Ayalin now joins us with details. Hi, Adrian. What can you tell us so far?
Yes, Stanley. Former Caloocan City 2nd District Representative Edgar Erice filed a petition for certiorari with a prayer for temporary restraining order against the Commission on Elections and Miro Systems before the Supreme Court. This is for the contract that Miro and COMELEC entered into worth 17 billion pesos for the 2025 automated election. Erice said in the petition that the contract should be declared null and void because of procurement irregularities. He also stressed that Miro will be using prototype machines, which is against the law. Erice also said the contract is, quote-unquote, a robbery in progress. Erice also said the filing is coincidental to the Supreme Court decision released yesterday, which found the COMELEC committing grave abuse of discretion for disqualifying another company, Smartmatic, in the bidding process. Erice said Smartmatic is not behind his petition. Erice also said he is contemplating on filing impeachment cases against COMELEC officials. Back to you, Stanley.
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Adrian Aline.